Good evening, everyone. So welcome to the second session of business communication. And today we'll discuss about the barriers, challenges, and global implication of the communication. Okay. Fine. So let's wait for everyone to join, I think, and then we'll start the class. Okay. So I think in the last session, we have discussed two case studies and verbal, non-verbal, oral, interpersonal communication. Mm-hmm. That's what we have covered up in the last session. Okay. So I think we should wait for Mr. Surya Prakash, please kindly mute yourself. Okay, so we are waiting for everyone to join and then we'll start the session. Okay, so let me share my screen with you. And yes, is my screen visible? Please kindly confirm.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So I think this was the, I think two case study we have covered up in the last class. That it was for the pitfall of the emails, that the mistake while actually sending the email reply to all, I think if you remember that we discussed. And one more case study which we discuss about the social media and its pros and cons when it comes to communication. That's what we have discussed. Okay, so today we'll discuss the one more case study, that is what the shoot companies that first, sorry, fire shoot first. That is again one more case study of communication. Before starting that case, today we will actually discuss the remaining topics of business communication. Okay, so what we have done till now. Yes, so we are done till this particular non-verbal, verbal and written communication. The next topic we have, that is about the organizational communication. Okay. So that I'm starting now, just a minute of time, please. So there are basically one diagram which I want to show you first when it's come to organizational communication. Okay. 1 minute, please. Yes. That is about the small group networks in an organization. Okay. That is the one diagram which we need. That is one more diagram which we have, that is called grapevine communication. Yes, sure. So let's start now, I think. So the next topic we have, that is organizational communication. Okay. So when we discuss about the organizational communication, the important part in the communication network, how the technology or how the technology is basically helping the organization when it's come to their interpersonal communication in the organization. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the interpersonal communication, which always associated with the formal and informal groups. Okay. Let me tie this. I think so. Better would be the thing would be. So when we discuss about any organizational communication, that starts with interpersonal communication. Now, these interpersonal communication may be actually, you could say, with the help of, you could say, formal or even grapevine. We discussed this grapevine in the last class. That is about the informal way of communication. That is more about the gossips, we can say. Okay. So now, when we discuss about the, you could say, communication network, okay, there are basically three common small group networks. Okay, there are three common small group network. Now, these which type of network we're talking right now? Basically, there are three network group. One is called chain, second is called wheel, and third is called all channels. That is called chain, wheel, and third is called all channel. Okay, what does it mean actually? I'll just show you the diagram. Okay. So when we discuss about this particular organizational communication and the chaining in the communication, we are actually talking about the important, you could say, criteria. The first one, that is about this basic diagram, about three small group network. You can see this particular on my screen as well. That is about the chain, wheel, and all channel. Now, what does it mean actually? Okay, when we discuss about the, you could say first formal communication, sorry, first organizational communication, which actually talks about the chain communication. Okay, now what is basically this chain communication? We will discuss it right now. Okay, first of all, we're discussing about the formal small group network. Okay, because these communication type may be formal and may be informal, depends on the way how the things were communicated among the members of the organization. Okay, so when we discuss about the formal, you could say, organizational communication, it is basically very complicated, first of all, and there are many people at different hierarchy are basically connected with each other. Okay, now in this case, we are actually dividing this formal small group communication into these three parts, that is chain, wheel, and all channel. Now, what type of communication the chain is all about? Anyone can guess, please?
So, like a chain from a top hierarchy to lower hierarchy.
Yes, yes, yes. Very good. Like even in a nutshell, if we talk about Ms. Poonam, that is, we could say, more rigidly followed formal communication. Okay. If it had been a simple language, we can say that
yes,
it is more rigid formal communication. Because as you can see this diagram as well, when we discuss about these type of communication, these communication always come from top management to their subordinates or to different hierarchy to then next hierarchy. So how this particular communication is actually going through, that would be the part of your chain communication. Is it clear, please, everyone? Yes, Surin, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Perfect. Now, the second call is the wheel communication. Wheel communication is basically more about, you could say, leadership-based communication. Because in this case, there is a central power who is called a leader. And in this leader, this particular leader is basically called the central figure in the company. The things will revolve around him. The things will actually move around him. And how the things can be, you could say, move further, how the policy could be designed, and what type of, you could say, communication is being, you could say, formulated by the top management, or you could say, not a top management even, by the particular individual that is called the leader of the company. That central figure will basically always guide you about how to move further. that is called the wheel communication. And wheel communication is basically more strong communication, and it is only because of the strong leader in the company. Okay. Now, next and the last part, which we talked about, the all channel communication. All channel communication means the communication with each other, irrespective of the hierarchy it belongs to. So everyone is free to contribute, and no one, you could say, or no person can take a particular leadership role. Okay. So in a simple language, if we talk about all wheel communication, this is basically associated with free to contribute, free to contribute. Okay. And when we discuss about these type of communication, there is no, you could say, a single person will take a leadership role. Okay. So, and no one takes on leadership role. This is basically the part of your, you could say, all channel communication. Is this point clear, please? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Clear, students? Perfect. Now, when we discuss about, this is a basically the formal communication channel we are talking right now. The second is basically all about the grapevine, or we can say the informal communication we are discussing right now. The first we are done, and second we are starting now. It is called grapevine communication. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the grapevine communication, Mr. Surya Prakash, please kindly mute yourself. Don't unmute unnecessarily. Okay. Yes. So when we discuss about the Mr. Surya Prakash, please.
Yes.
The second point we have, that is about the informal communication, which is called the grapevine. Okay. Now, what is grapevine? I think we have also discussed in the last class how the informal communication basically, you could say, helping the company somehow, as well as destroying the company's, you could say, cohesiveness when we come to the communication channel or communication partner. Okay. So grapevine is basically based on rumors, based on gossip. These gossips are basically the part of your grapevine. So I'll explain you here only. When we discuss about the grapevine communication, this grapevine communication is basically more about, you could say, informal communication based on rumors, based on rumors and gossips, based on rumors and gossips. Okay. Now, in this case, it is very important that whatever gossip or whatever communication is going on, most of the time in any company, this grapevine is the most important and the most, you could say, effective way of communication in any organization, because this is more informal, and each and every individual always on the back of the, you could say, a leader or a manager of the company about their working responsibility or their working culture in the company. Okay. Now, one more important thing when we discuss about this particular part, 1 minute, that is about the effective criteria, that which particular communication is, you could say, more effective when we come to the type of communication. Just kindly see this, please, first. That is the criteria of communication, first of all, that is about the chain, network wheel, or all channels. Speed is definitely very, very high when it's come to all channel and network. Accuracy is definitely moderate, but high would be in the chain because the communication always come from higher authorities. Emergence of a leader definitely would be very high in the network because it is more about a leadership channel. And member satisfaction would be very, very high because each and everyone can contribute into the communication network. Clear, everyone, please.
Yes, sir.
Yes, friends. Everyone, please kindly confirm. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Perfect, perfect. Now, I will just actually discuss one very basic, not a case study, but basically a statement about the ethical choice. Okay. Not a case study, but you could say an important, you could say component about ethics of gossip at work. Like, even though if you gossip, what is gossip, first of all? It's very important to understand. What is gossip? It is talking on the back of the, you could say, the manager or your company's head. That is basically the gossip, we can say. Okay. Now, in this particular, you could say, PPT we are talking right now, I'll just give a particular basic situation in which how the gossip could be, you could say, ethically, you could say, understand or ethically can be understood by the company's operation. Just kind of read this once, please. The ethical choice, the ethics of gossip at work. Even though if the company is going or company's members are going through informal communication, but how the gossip is actually playing a crucial role, that we need to understand. Okay, please have a look, students. And giving you 10 minutes of time for that, 5 to 10 minutes. Do it fast, please. We'll discuss about this. It's very important, you could say, case right now. Yes, we're done, I think. Poonam Jidan. Okay, good, good. Always, I think you are first. Yes, what about other students? Is it done? Very simple, I think, one situation about the gossips and its ethics. Yes, Miss Poonam. Shall we start with you, I think?
Yes, sir. Gossip here is taken as both positive and negative aspects. But at many level, it is not good because the authorities goes down. And the secret, whatever the secrets about the authority goes down. In positive sense, the gossip is because the some type of anxiety or any frustrations from the persons goes out. In the negative sense, if it is wrong information, is infused in the organization, it has the bad consequences. So final decision in the according to the in this case study that. Whatever we gossip, let the person who is about we are gossiping or the number of person who are gossiping each other must contribute.
Definitely.
Yes.
Now, what you understood, like when we talk about like the last paragraph you mentioned, that whenever possible,
yes,
let the person you are talking about to have a chance to enter a discussion at some later point, so his or her view can be explicitly taken into account. For example, like Poonam is my colleague and I'm just talking about my boss that how actually badly he has actually treated the employee or whatsoever it could be, or how he is treated to us as well. That we were discussing actually. But I think before actually coming to a conclusion, we also need to actually keep in loop to the, you could say aspect of the boss, why he actually behaving in such a manner in the organization. So at least see that why should always be there. And you always need to understand the empathy of that particular individual, why someone is behaving in a certain manner in the organization.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Perfect, Kunal. Thank you.
The managers who are at the top level, so they should be involved in gossip, sir.
See, usually what happens, generally when we talk about the same level employee and the informal groups are created, you can actually keep in loop to a particular person from same level. But definitely person belongs to higher authority or higher hierarchy. It is now practically possible actually to keep him or her in the loop actually.
Okay, sir.
It is only possible like what I can personally say with the help of any third party.
Okay, sir.
Clear, I think.
Yes.
Perfect. Yes, anyone else? I think having any other view regarding this? I think we have covered up almost all the things. Okay. So let's start, I think, with the next part now. That is about the electronic communication. Okay. The next topic.
Okay.
The next topic we have, which is called electronic communication. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the electronic communication is basically more about, you could say, indispensable in the company. And around, we can say that 70 to 80% of the work in any organization always come through electronic communication. Okay. So, modes of electronic communication yes, what are the different modes of electronic communication, please? Email, text messages, networking software, we talk about blogs, video conferencing, etc. Okay. Now, when we discuss about all these different type of communication, definitely we know about this communication very, very easily. What is email communication? Everyone knows about, I think so. Yes, students, I think. What is email communication? Everyone knows about.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think let's discuss all these points. I think we did drawbacks as well. Okay. Yes. So I will go for in detail about all these topics as well. Okay. So let's start, I think, with the first part, that is email communication. Okay. Now, email, I think we already know, that is about the electronic mail. And these mail is actually say transmit and receive through computer generated text and documentation. Okay. When we talk about this email communication, it is very quickly written, edited and stored, first of all. Okay. So first of all, it uses internet to transmit and receive computer generated text and documents. Computer generated text and documents. Okay. Now these actually emails are very quick, edited and stored. Okay, that is a very important discussion which we are discussing right now. Now, when we discuss about the email communication, this is, you could say, a formal way of communication or formal message of communication. In any organization, if you talk about, okay. Now, certain drawbacks are also there for email communication. What drawbacks we can cover up under email communication, please? Anyone? The first drawback we are talking about, risk of misinterpretation of message. Risk of misinterpretation of message, because basically person is not physically available or not front face to face available in order to communicate that message. And that message basically communicated with the help of email, and how a particular person are interpreting such messages. That is again the important part of the email communication. Okay. The second part we have, that is about the drawbacks, that is communicating negative messages. Communicating negative messages. Because somehow it happens that because of certain, you could say, issues, some politics in the company, it may be possible that that negative message will be always available for, you could say, authorities, and the certain actions can be taken. Again, all those individual. Okay. The third part is about time consuming in nature. Okay. This is time consuming in nature. Okay. And when we discuss about, you could say, the basic, you could say, drawbacks we are talking right now. But what are the basic, you could say, what I can say, basic points we are talking right now about the strategies, how a particular, you could say, email uses can be more effective and easy for an individual. Okay, so we're discussing right now strategies of checking emails in professional life. Okay, anyone, any idea, please? Any inputs? Yes, friend, anyone having any idea? Like very basic fundamental, if I'll tell you from my side as well, I never ever check my email in the morning, because you know that the timing of office is 10 to 5, 10 to 6, 11 to 7, whatsoever. You always need to check your mail during official time or after the official time, or you could say at the end of the official timings. Okay. The first thing is all about, don't check email in the morning. It's my experience, I'm telling you. Okay. Next one, check email in batches. Batches means you need to check the email at a single shot. For example, if I'm checking my email at 12 o'clock, then 3 o'clock, then 6 o'clock. That is the, what you could say, one of the most, you could say, important strategy at the start of the office, mid of the office, end of the office. What else?
I think mid of the office, sir.
Yeah, mid of the office definitely, sir. But usually, like when you talk about the formal practices, like what I personally do, I do it in the morning when the office starts. Like for example, 10 o'clock, I check around 10, 30, 11. Okay, the very start of the office. Then post lunch, and then at the before, you could say ending up of the business.
Basically, most criteria is after the post lunch. Post lunch is all is covered, I think so.
But I think, sir, what we can say in this case depends on the industry. Like we belong to academics. Okay. So somehow we have some meetings in the afternoon or some, you could say, circulars are there. So in that cases, at least it's a need of the department as well.
And according, but this is the internal, this is the internal, is the outsource you find out, then this is in part of the post-lunch. Post-lunch, yes, you can get.
Definitely. Yeah. Yes, for third party, for external user, definitely you have to go for some external, that may be post-lunch as well. Okay. Next one. Unsubscribe unnecessary content. You can see that. Now, even like if you're subscribing to any website or any, you could say, hotel or whatsoever services, they will continuously sending you email for their promotions. Okay. So, unsubscribe the newsletter and others, you could say, unnecessary emails. Okay. Next one. Stop sending, might be it is laughing for you, stop sending email. Okay, now what is stop sending email? Means stop sending unnecessary email, I think so. Because what the people do, even for a single minute part, like which they can discuss over call as well, or which is not, you could say, officially required on the paper or on the record, they even they for the same, they also send the mail. So stop sending email until not required. Okay. Any idea, please? Anyone, anything else about this strategy of checking email in professional life?
Before sending any mail, we need to first we need to check the receiver's email ID, verify receiver's email ID.
Yes, that is, we can say, the credibility or authenticity of sender.
Yeah, authenticity.
Okay, very good. Authenticity 1 minute. Thencity. Authenticity. Authentic. Or you could say authentic senders. Or authentic sources, I think we can say. Or you could say checking of authentic sources. Because grammatically it is not correct. Checking of authentic sources. That is very important part. Very good.
Basically sources is important, sir.
Definitely, sir. Okay. Now, next, I think two more points which we can cover up under this drawbacks that I can say about limited expressions and emotions. Limited expressions and emotions. Okay. And the fifth and the important point about the privacy concern. Okay. Because about your, if someone knows about your ID, password, or it can be hacked as well. So privacy concerns are always there when we come to emails. Yes, clear students, I think everyone.
Okay, sir.
Okay, perfect. So second one, I think we have after email, we have text messages. Okay. Or you could say instant messaging services. Okay. So instant messaging. Instant messaging and text messaging. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the instant messaging and the text messaging, okay, what are the different, you could say, mode of instant and text messaging? Definitely through SMS. When you talk about even what I can say, SMS, that is simple messaging services. We talk about iMessages when we talk about Apple products or between two Apple users. We talk about BlackBerry, if you remember. BlackBerry having its own messaging services. Okay. So BlackBerry, iPhone. These are the major, you could say, telephone services. Those who are providing their services when it's come to instant and text messaging. I think clear, students? It's very simple. Anji. Yes, students. Is it clear? I think it's very simple. It is.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. Now, the you could say the most drawbacks of this particular instant messaging or text messaging. It is all about the abbreviation. Okay, because in this particular text messaging, the person might use informality or informal, you could say content, informal content. Like we talk about OMG, are you serious? Are you serious? BRB and all the short form. So person might use informal content like BRB, OMG, are you serious? This is basically the blunder of the instant messaging when it's come to formal communication, actually. Okay. You always need to avoid jargons and what I can say, slang in your text messages or your instant messages. Okay. That is the important part when we come to, you could say, instant messaging or text messaging. Okay. You always need to use, you could say, some formal lines. You need to take care about the pattern in which you are writing it out. The punctuation, the grammar, each and everything should be properly monitored and designed. Okay. So grammar. Punctuations, format. Then flow of the content, etc. Need to be. Or etc. Must be properly synchronized. Clear, I think, everyone? Very simple about text messaging as well. Yes, students. Is it clear, please, everyone? Next one, I think we have social media, okay, or social networking. And as you can see that, I think yesterday we discussed about one case study as well on social networking. So what is social networking? As everyone knows about, that includes your Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn,
Snapchat.
There are a lot of things are there actually.
WhatsApp.
Okay. So again, I think if you remember the last case study which we talked about, which was a case of social media only. In this case, when we are talking about, you could say such, you could say social media content, the formal way of social media, how the media should be restricted when it's come to workplaces, each and everything should be thoroughly analyzed and thoroughly, you could say, monitored by the authorities in the organization. Okay, so that is the basically the part of social media, I think, that we have already covered up in the last class. Okay, about the pros and cons of social media. Yes, students, clear, I think?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, then we have blogs. This is blogs. Okay, what is blog then? Blogs are basically called the web blogs, okay? We didn't write down, I think, web blogs. Okay? Now, when we talk about web blogs, what is this? It is usually, you can say, a website for a company or an individual. Where they can write down their content, they write down their information. Okay. And when we discuss about the blogging, blogging is basically, you could say, very, very famous when it comes to the modern world. Can you give the best example of blogging? I think it's very, very famous. Yes, students, anyone? You heard about Twitter? It is basically, you could say, more about a social social media as well as the blogging. But Twitter is the best blogging website, or you could say best blogging application in the world right now, which is being used by most of the formal, you could say, for formal communication.
Stacko?
Yes, pardon?
Stacko?
I didn't heard this word actually as of now. What is it actually? It is again the type of Twitter?
Sorry, sir?
Yes, yes. What it is actually exactly? Because we don't know.
Stacko, fans of the blog, sir.
Okay, fine. Because I never heard this, that's the reason I asked you.
Ah, okay, sir, it's okay.
Now, after web blogs, we have video conferencing. And right now, because of pandemic, you can see that, as you could say, more fashionable in the market when it's come to formal communication. So video conferencing, maybe you could say, done with the help of Zoom, Google Meet, when we come to WebEx, Cisco WebEx. What else?
Teams.
Microsoft Teams. I think there is one more I'm not
think about.
Pardon?
Might be Skype.
Skype, definitely. It is being used for video conferencing. Very good. What else? I think major we have all covered up actually. When we come to the...
Excuse me, sir. WhatsApp also, I think so.
WhatsApp video conferencing.
Yeah.
See, now but, it has been started. Okay. Recently it has started actually.
4-5
It is WhatsApp, I think.
This is also group call, na, sir? WhatsApp.
Yes. I'm just checking it actually. What exactly the name of that? It is WhatsApp. One minute. Yes. I think it is WhatsApp group call, I think only. There is nothing new is mentioned in that, I think. Yes, perfect. Okay, so what next? I think after that, when it's come to communication, that is, I think that is already done. Then we have, yes, choice of communication channel, the next topic now. Okay. Choices of communication channel. Okay. So just wait a minute. I'm just copying one diagram for you. That is choices of communication channel. Very simple topic. It is again like when we come to choices of communication. So let me share my screen and yes. So the major, you could say, point which we come under choice of communication, that you can see that low channel richness, high channel richness. What are the credibility and different modes through which we can communicate? Yes, we'll have a look and Lou, let me know. I think we have discussed all the points actually for this communication channel type and which channel would be most suitable when it's come to richness and credibility. Yes, students, any doubt in this space? understood what is richness of the channel? Yes, you understood, I think. Then we'll discuss about the last topic of this unit, second last topic. That is persuasive communication. Barriers to effective communication and the global implication. These last two topics we'll discuss now. And one case study. Yes, friend. Is it clear? I think everyone.
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Okay, perfect. So I think we are going for a break of 10 minutes now, and we'll discuss the last three main topic. That is barriers to communication, then global implication, and the case study. These are the three topics left now. Okay. So we are going for a break of 10 minutes and we'll get back to 6:05 sharp now. Okay, everyone?
Okay.
Perfect. Yes, students. So let's start with the next topic then. That is about the barriers of communication. Okay. So when we discuss about this particular topic, barriers to effective communication, what are the major barriers what you can understand, like what you will suggest as of now when we come to barriers? The first one is, anyone please? Barriers of communication.
So first of all, it is of language barrier.
Yes, very good. Language would be one of the barrier. What else? Emotions, silence of your subordinate when you are talking to him or her regarding any issue. Okay, lying. Okay, that is again one of the important barriers of communication. So I'm just going with the formal process about this barrier of communication. Thank you, Ms. Poonam. So let's start with the very first part right now. That is about the filtering. What is filtering, I think, anyone? Any common example? That is information manipulation. What does it mean? Any example, please? Yes, students. Any example of this? I think I'm not getting the voice of the student today. What happened? Is everything all right? Yes, Ms. Poonam. Yes, students, I think, am I clearly audible? Anji.
Any information we provide to the receiver with false perception.
Definitely. Because that is all about the alteration and the you could say the filtration and the you could say the manipulation or the changes in the original form of that particular message. Okay, for example, if I have communicated to you that this is the actual process and how we need to actually process this project instead of 1, 2, 5 and so many things are there. How it was being communicated from the boss to manager and from manager to subordinate, from subordinate to any other individual. Definitely these process or these particular, you could say, the passing of the information from one person to other may have certain manipulation. And even these particular practices, we also experience in our personal life as well, how the things could be filtered when it's come to information manipulation. I hope so. Everyone understood this part. Students, please. Filtering.
Yes, sir. In real life, it happens, this filtering only.
Yes, definitely.
From top level, from manager level to the associate level, the information which is passed is fully manipulated.
Yes. So distortion of information is basically the major part in filtering. Like even in the personal life as well, I think, if we talk about, these practices are very common. Like when we come to family relationship or when we come to even husband and wife, even like what are the communication among the, you could say, group, when we come to our friends and families, if we talk about how the information is passing from my uncle to my aunt to their relatives and so many things are there. Things are completely distorted how it has been started actually. So somehow this is a major reason behind the disturbance in most of the relationship as well. Okay, when it comes to filtering process. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, perfect, perfect. Thank you. Second is selective perception. What is selective perception? Means he will hear, he will actually understand, he will actually focus only up to an extent which is important. For example, we are sitting in a meeting in the company. And and when we come, like, for example, being in a company, you are a marketing manager of the company. And once the marketing manager discussion is done for the day and the other department discussion are going on, what you will do? You will try to ignore. You will not focus that much what exactly you will focus once your turn will come when it's come to your department. Selective perception. Okay. So he will receive only, you could say, that much only, which is, you could say, in a simple language that, see and hear based on their needs, motivations, experience, background and any other personal characteristics, etc. This is basically called the selective perception. I hope so it is clear, students. Very simple. Next part we have, that is called information overload. In a particular day, for example, if I'm taking your lectures for 7 hours for a particular technical topic, is it possible for you to digest? Definitely no. For starting 2 to 3 hours, things would be quite okay. But when the things will go beyond the digestion capacity, beyond the capacity of a particular audience, definitely it is infinite overload. That is called the overcapacity. Or you could say up to capacity, things are digestible or things are understood by the individual. That's the reason, like in the college as well, like whenever we have the classes, this class is only for up to 2 hours or 3 hours max to max in a particular day. Okay, that is called information overloading. Next, we have emotions. Now, definitely, as we know that emotions always play a very crucial role. Okay, like if someone basically is in the positive mode, he's more confident, then definitely their message would be more persuasive. Okay, but someone like who is very, you could say, negative opinion, negative mood, he might actually scrutinize those things in the negative aspect as well. So the emotions always play a very good role. Emotions means basically we're talking about the mood of receiver or mindset of receiver. Accordingly, things may be perceived, things may be received by a particular individual. Okay? Yes, students, clear? I think so. Yes, and is it clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, next one we have, that is called language. Okay. Now, what about language? Like, rightly, I think Poonam suggests that. What about language? Definitely, you can see that if you are communicating the same language, definitely you can understand very, very easily. But the language is quite different. Definitely, you cannot communicate what exactly the person wants to hear, what person wants to understand. Okay. Next one is silence. Silence means once you're talking to a particular person, but he is not responsive. He is not actually giving any response. That is called irresponsive in its behavior. Okay, that is called the silence approach. Okay, next one, I think we have communication apprehension. communication, apprehension. Okay. What is communication apprehension, first of all? Yes, students, social anxiety, I think you understand the word. They always feel, you could say, conscious when they are talking in public. Okay, for example, there are people, those who cannot speak publicly, but they can actually speak in their comfort environment. That is called communication apprehension. Okay, means so people do have social anxiety, how to talk to in front of group of people, fear, stage fear we have, eye contact is not there, nervousness, these all will come under communication apprehension. The last very simple one, that is called lying. Jhoot bolna. That is a very, very important, actually a very simple way how the things are basically communicated when we come to lying. Okay. Is it clear, please, everyone? Yes, students.
Yes, it's clear.
Perfect. So this is all about the, you could say, important barriers to communication. Okay. Now, when we talk about the, you could say, global implication or the global barriers or the global aspect of communication, we'll discuss the last point topic now for this particular chapter. Okay. So last topic, that is about the global implications. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the global implications, the first important aspect when we come to that is called cultural barriers, which is very common, I think, throughout the world. If you talk about the, you could say, the business between two countries, multiple countries, we always face the challenges when it's come to cultural differences. Second one, cultural context. Second one is cultural context. What is cultural context, please, anyone? Yes, students, what is cultural context? That is about the way how a particular person communicate. Like we talk about the countries like China, Korea, Japan, Vietnam, they actually believe in actually high cultural context because they have more about, you could say, non-verbal communication when they are communicating with each other. They have a more way how to respect when it's come to communication. So there's a major, you could say, point when it comes to cultural context. So cultural context is basically all about how a particular person and the term, how they communicate with each other. Okay, that is again the important part when we come to cultural communication. Like we talk about European countries like German, Swiss, North America. These are basically the countries with low cultural context. Okay, so I'll just give you an understanding about what is cultural context. It is nothing but, that is about the communication and you could say the way how the things would be, you could say, more communicated with the help of non-verbal communication. Societal status, we talk about society, place, reputation are considerably weightage. It is called high cultural. Okay, so cultural context, maybe you could say high and you could say it may be low as well. Okay, cultural context, it may be high, sorry, or low. High we talk about, you could say it is basically the understanding of. One minute, I just actually copy one diagram over here. Wait a minute, please. This is a diagram I just want to show you. One minute, please. Because of the cultural context. One minute, please. Yes, you can see that this diagram about high cultural context. I'll just copy this over here. So diagram which I want to show you about the cultural context. Yes, this is the diagram actually, that is called the cultural context. Okay, the high cultural context, you can actually understand, you can actually go through with it. So this is basically the context of cultural context. High cultural context means the more respect, most non-verbal communication. They know how to communicate in public, society, and they always talk respectfully. So that will be the part of your cultural context. Clear, everyone? Haji, is this clear, please, everyone? The global implication of the communication. If it is done, then we'll start the last case study of this particular topic, and from tomorrow we'll start the new topic now. Okay, so let me share that that case study as well now, the last case study. Yesterday we have discussed this pitfall of email and using social media to your advantage, and today we'll discuss the last case study. Should company that fire shoot first? Okay, so this is the case study we'll discuss now. Let me share my screen with you. And we'll start discussing all these topics now. So last case study of the topic, that is about communication. I hope the is the screen visible to everyone? Should company that fire shoot first? Is it visible, please, everyone?
Yes, it's visible.
Perfect, perfect. So just go through with this and we'll discuss this last case study. And we're done for the day as well. So we'll start discussing at sharp 6:30 now. Okay, 6:20 right now. Please do it fast. Yes, friend, done everyone with this case study? Because again, it's a very simple case study when it's come to communication network about the, you could say, errors of social networking and how these errors can actually implement it, and that errors basically may ruin, you could say, companies processing in the long run as well. Okay. So that is basically the very basic case study. And yesterday, I think if you remember, we discussed these two cases as well. Social media to their advantage, and should companies that fire shoot first. Anyone who can summarize this case, please? Yes, students? Anyone? Yes, Ms. Poonam, you want to say something?
So the company is talking about the traditional traditional media of a layoff. Like in emails, there was input placed that why they are layoff or anything. And the modern trend, they are, if they are blogs are using for them. So the one who has been laid out is saying that we should go for traditional media, not for going for a blogs or anything that everybody in the social media should know that how, what percentage of persons are laid out from the company.
Okay.
So that I understood.
Okay. Fine. Anyone else, please? Yes, sir. Anyone else, please, about this case study? But now we are done with this topic of communication. Okay. And tomorrow we'll discuss, I think, the next 3 days, we'll discuss the remaining topic of the syllabus. And then we are done with this OB subject, actually. Okay. Okay, students. So, any more query, please, to anyone from the session, I think, regarding the topic communication?
Basically, sir, this is the right communication and the right way. I think so. Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes. Please, Mr. Anuj, continue.
Basically, this case is really the communication, related to the communication, but in the right communication, right time, and it will be take the right decision. I think so.
Yeah, but actually, like, as per this case study, things would be, I think, quite acceptable. Okay, but when we come to the things should be generalized for such cases, I think it is not possible to implement, you could say, the way how this case study was constructed or how this particular situation was constructed. It might not be valid in all the cases, or we can say we cannot generalize this particular situation.
But the, depending on the situation, na, sir. Depending, yes, on the situation.
Yes.
That will be communicated.
Perfect, Mr. Anuj.
Okay.
Yeah. So, students, any more doubt from the topic? This is communication, please.
No, sir.
Okay, perfect. So, student, we'll get you tomorrow now with the remaining topic of this particular subject, and we'll start. Okay, thank you so much, everyone, and we'll catch you tomorrow now. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.